Hello friends, welcome to my channel. Today in this video we are going to make cushion cover and we are making granny squares for that. This pattern is very easy to make and even a beginner can try to make this. The techniques that I have applied in making this project are chains, single crochet and double crochet. So we are going to begin now. Things that we require for this project are yarn of two colors. The choice of colors depend on you, a pair of scissors, needle to stitch the squares all together, and a hook that could match to the thickness of the yarn. So we are going to begin now. At first, we have to pick up the tail of the yarn of color A, make a loop, insert the hook in, pull through to make a slip knot. Now yarn over, pull through, pull through, pull through, and pull through. These are four chains. We have to go back to the first chain, insert the hook in, yarn over, pull through both the loops. This is slip stitch. Now foundation ring is ready. Chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet, yarn over, insert the hook into the ring, pull through. There are three loops on the hook, pull through 2, pull through 2. This is double crochet. So there are two double crochet. Now double crochet 3, chain 2 for chain space, yarn over, insert the hook into the ring, pull through 2, pull through 2, double crochet 1, double crochet 2 and double crochet 3, chain 2 for chain space, yarn over, double crochet 1 again, 2 and 3, chain 2 for chain space, again we have to make 3 double crochet, 1, 2 and 3, chain 2 for chain space. Now we have to join the stitches into the 4th, 2nd, 3rd chain of the 4th stitch, so insert the hook in, pull through 2. Now we have to turn the pattern and we have to come back to the chain space of 2 with single crochet. Turn the pattern again, chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet 1, double crochet 2. Chain 2 for chain space. Into the next chain space of 2, we have to make 2 clusters of double crochet and there would be 3 double crochet in each cluster. So double crochet 1, two and three, chain two for chain space. Into the same chain space of two we have to make one more cluster, so double crochet 1, 2 and 3, chain two for chain space. Into the next chain space of two, double crochet 1, 2 and 3. Chain 2 for chain space, into the same chain space of 2, one more cluster of double crochet. So double crochet 1, double crochet 2 and double crochet 3. Chain 2 for chain space, into the next chain space of 2, double crochet 1, 2 and 3. Chain 2 for chain space, one more cluster of double crochet, chain 2 for chain space. Now into this first chain space of 2 where we began the pattern, we have to make one cluster of double crochet. So double crochet 1, 2 and 3, chain 2 for chain space. Now we have to join the stitches into the third chain of the fourth stitch with slip stitch. We have to turn the pattern and we have to come back to the chain space of 2 with single crochet. Chain 1, 2, 3, which counts as a double crochet. Double crochet 1, double crochet 2. Chain 2 for chain space. into the next chain space of 2 for the side of the square, we have to make one cluster of double crochet. So double crochet 1, 2 and 3. Chain 2 for chain space. Now for the corner of the square, into this chain space of 2, we have to make 2 clusters of double crochet. So double crochet 1, two and three. Chain two for chain space. Into the same chain space of 2, double crochet 1, 2 and 3. So complete the round following the same pattern. For each side of the square, we have to make one cluster of double crochet, while for the corner of the square, we have to make 2 clusters of double crochet. Complete the round and we will meet again when this round would be completed. When this round is complete, we have to make chain 2. Now into this chain space of 2, for the corner of the square, we have to make one more cluster of double crochet. So double crochet 1, 2 and 3. Chain 2 for chain space. Now we have to join the stitches into the third chain of the fourth stitch with slip stitch. This round is complete. Now we have to cut the yarn from here because we are going to add next color to the pattern. Now to add next color, take the tail of the yarn, make a loop, insert the hook and pull through to make a slip knot. Now we have to join the yarn into the chain space of 2 with single crochet. Chain 1, 2, 3. And now we have to make 2 more double crochet to complete the cluster. So double crochet 1, 2 and 3. Chain 2 for chain space. Into the next chain space of 2, one cluster of double crochet. So double crochet 1, 2 and 3. Chain 2 for chain space. Into the next chain space of 2, double crochet 1, 2 and 3. Chain 2 for chain space. Into the next chain space of 2, we have to make 2 clusters of double crochet for the corner of the square. So double crochet 1, 2 and 3. Chain 2 for chain space. Into the same chain space of 2, double crochet 1, 2 and 3. Now we have to complete this round and one more round with this color. In this round, we would have 2 chain spaces for each corner of the square, where we have to make 2 clusters separately for each chain space of 2 for each side of the square. But in the next round, we would have 3 chain spaces of 2, where we have to make 3 sets of double crochet into each chain space of 2. So complete making 2 more rounds with this color. And we would meet again when these 2 rounds would be completed. When these 2 rounds are completed, we have to cut the yarn. Now, one square is complete. As you can see, we have made one set of double crochet into each chain space of 2 for the sides of the square. And for the corner of the square, there are 2 sets of double crochet. Now, we have to complete making 15 more squares for one side of the cushion cover. This would be the front side, and for the back side we have to make 16 more squares. So total there would be 32 squares for cushion cover. So complete making 32 squares and we would meet again when these squares would be completed. When we have completed making squares, we have to now join them using needle and thread. You can join these squares by crocheting as well. So join these 2 squares by simple stitches. And this is how we have to join all the 16 squares for the front part of the cushion cover and 16 other parts for the back part of the cushion cover in the same way. So complete joining all these squares together, and we will meet again when these squares will be stitched together. Like this. Now we have completed joining all these squares together. So this is the front part of the cushion cover, while this is the back part of the cushion cover. Now we have to make edging with color A, as I have made in this part, back part of the cushion cover. We have to follow the same pattern, and into each chain space of 2 we have to make one set of double crochet, while for the corner of the square we have to make 2 sets of double crochet with chain space of 2 in between them. So complete making edging in this part as well, and then we will join these parts together to make a cushion cover. So complete making edging following the same pattern. When we have completed making edging on both the sides of the cushion cover, we have to add zipper to the mouth of the cushion cover. For this, we need needle and thread to attach this zipper to the mouth of the cushion cover. Now we are going to attach this zipper with simple stitches. So take a part of the cushion cover and join the zipper following this stitch pattern. So complete attaching this zipper to both the sides of the cushion cover, and we will meet again when this zipper would be attached together. When the zipper is joined together, we are going to join now all the remaining 3 sides of the cushion cover. So take the tail of the yarn, make a loop, insert the hook and pull through to make a slip knot. Now put the edge of the zipper inside the 2 parts. Now insert the hook into both the stitches of both the parts. Pull through 2. Again, into the next stitch, insert the hook into both the stitches of both the parts, pull through 2. Again, into next 2 stitches of both the parts, insert the hook and pull through 2. In this way, we have to join all the remaining 3 sides of the cushion cover with this simple stitch. So complete joining the remaining 3 parts of the cushion cover following the same pattern, and we will meet again when these parts would be joined together. When we have completed joining all the 3 sides of this cushion cover, this cushion cover will be completed. This pattern can be used for making blankets, baby blankets, for table cover, table runner, table mats, and so forth and so on. Thank you so much.